Hey guys, welcome back. Today we're going to be doing the Artifact of the Immune. You'll notice we're exiting a little base out in the Redwoods. You also notice over the last episode, we tamed up a Basilosaur. Preparation for an underwater cave. Now with this cave has a little trick to it. You can't just waltz in here. I think it's right up to this little point right over here. Going any further, and you'll start dying pretty quickly. To counter this, all you need is a gas mask. And that is it. Now let's make our way through this cave. Now this cave is really, really hostile. And creature levels are enhanced. So you're gonna see like level 500 to 700 enemies. So we're just gonna kinda crawl through this cave. Alright, we're just going to make our way in. Now your biggest threat are Arthropleuros. You don't want to get hit by them. And boom, like that we lost our gas mask. Put another one on so we don't die. And then kill this Arthropleuro before he breaks another one. We're gonna backpack up into this cave and lure the creatures in more. Alright, as you go through this cave, just take your time with it. Watch out for snakes in the ceiling. Now, I don't know the actual path of the artifact, because it's just too toxic. So, when you get to this little pool of water, if you look up there, you'll see a little opening in the cave. Make sure it's safe, because you will probably die if it's not. Oh, you gotta make sure you have a grappling hook for this part, too. Kind of forgot that. There we go. Oh, and just like that, the baryonyx killed a snake. Bam, now we have the artifact of the immune. A fairly easy artifact to grab. Now we make our way back out. Just remember, all you need for this cave is a gas mask. Nothing else. Now, I forgot to bring the otter, so we're just going to build a little box inside the base here and go harvest the next one. Do a little item maintenance real quick before we head back into the cave. Now, the gas masks aren't infinite. They have, they slowly decrease use as you wear it. So, let's see if we can't get, like, 4 artifacts out of this cave today. Alright, that was the second artifact. Let's push forward into the cave, see what else we can't find. While we wait for another one to respawn. Alright, for now let's take off the gas mask so we can preserve it. And let's go get this guy some fish, because I'm noticing he's hungry and I don't have fish. Alright, now that we got fish, let's go back up to the cave and sit there for a few minutes, wait for it to respond still. Alright, let's head back into the cave, see if it's responded yet. Let's not forget to put the gas mask back on. Careful, stuff does respawn. May not be a lot, but definitely stuff respawning. There we go, took down the Arthroplura before we could shatter the gas mask again. Artifact was definitely back. I saw the glow. First, clear out some of this hallway. Not really a hard artifact once you've done it a few times. There we go. Now we'll wait probably a good 10 more minutes and get one more. This way, if we need it again, we can just visit the little hut outside the cave. Actually, 3 should be good enough. So in that case, let's take this guy, head back to base. Oh, looks like the baryonyx I didn't want ended up getting crushed somewhere in the swamp. Alright, now that we're back at base, let's run through the inventory real quick. And as soon as we get 100 black pearls, we're gonna go out squid taming. And then once we have that squid, we're gonna raise it up. And then we're gonna hit both of the underwater caves with it. Alright, let's take Fang. There we go. Let's go skirt the beach, see if we can't find some more trilobites to munch on real quick. Thank you. Well, I'm not seeing any trilobites. Only one. So be it. The Black Pearl hunt is gonna be a little bit of a grind. Alright, now the next cave is gonna be an Arctic cave. So, we're gonna switch our ghillie armor for some fur. Now, this cave is small. So, unfortunately, you're going to be going in on this one on foot. Let's see, grab some of our fur armor. Should have enough items on us to get through it. It's not a real big cave, so that's a plus side of it. I believe we got enough prep work for it. For now, we can release the berry. He can chill at base. We're not gonna need him. Remember to take our little Dimorphodon. He is going to come into play in this cave quite a bit. And off we go. Now this cave is nestled right on the cliff ledge, but there's plenty of room to fly an Argent onto it and then kind of block it off. Almost there. Once you get up to the northern border, you want to just keep following the coastline to the west. After we tag this artifact a couple times, get a little stockpile built, we'll head to the Artifact of the Strong next. Our little raft. I completely forgot we even put that out here. Should probably check it out to see if it's got anything useful. I doubt it. I probably already cleaned it out. Alright, and that's the entrance for the Artifact of the Skylord Cave. There we go. Look at that, just a stray Argon already flying up. So, all we're gonna do to block this off. Just some foundations and walls. Just a simple block. There we go. Doesn't have to be a perfect shelter, just... No, it's turning into kind of an ugly shelter, but so be it. We're nearing the end of the island. That is a fact. Should be safe enough now to hop off. There we go. And like always, we'll keep him on neutral. Just in case. Alright guys, that's gonna cut this one. Next one, we're gonna enter the Skylord cave and go grab us some more artifacts.